Hello everyone, my name is Flabblister and we have returned back to be a Miniki fan game with Somatsuki in Ultraviolet. I do not know if I've pronounced her name correctly. And yes, it looks like we've emerged in a dark room. And it's come from this scenario over here where we recited, which we went through the first time when we originally came into this Let's Play on the first episode. But now that we've got the lamppost, we're going to be able to see what's going on in here. And hopefully we'll be able to find something of this. But if we cannot, then we're just going to have to simply accept the fact that we're going to need more in order to progress through the game. And, no, there's still this avenue over here. God, this is a really convoluted path. Go over here. And then go over this way. I don't know what these labels over here are. And then go upstairs. And then, okay, we don't need the light anymore, but I'm still going to equip it just in case there are other dark rooms. You never know what may be behold. The rooms themselves, I mean. So this room's got a lot of blood in it. What the heck is going on in this place? It seems like a bit of a hospital. Just because of the layout in the room itself. There's a lot of blood there. What the heck is inside this? I don't think we can interact with it for some odd reason, but that is sure a bit scary. Go through here then and see what's what. Oh, there must be a monitor up here. Right. Okie dokie. It's a simple game of Simon Says then. Excellent. And that shall be that indeed. Oh golly. That opens up the locker and look at what's inside. A nail hammer. Are you not go? Oh my, I saw that thing moving in there. What the hell can we do with a nail hammer? Well, obviously we can kill NPCs with this nail hammer. As much as the blood itself looks a bit unrealistic, it seems to have different paint patterns on it when the artist drew it in here. So some smudges look much, much, much thicker than other smudges. It's Somatsuki lighter than we thought, or darker than we thought? Well, with that nail hammer and that scene over there, it looks like there's going to be some sort of darkness in this game. But still holding that sort of light element about it. Right, we simply can't get across over to that side of the scenario. Now that we're back in the Nexus, it's time for us to go into the fourth floor of this scenario. But I just want to check this room just in quickly. I believe we've been there before, I can't quite remember. Okay, so now we are transpiring within this world of glitter, jewelry, and however you want to call it. Can we use the nail hammer on such creatures? Oh, we can use it on such creatures. Oh, dear me. This is what the power of the nail hammer does. First, you insert the nail, and then you use the hammer on the nail to insert a rather sharp attack using the nail and the force of a hammer. But I don't think anything comes out from all this. Something broken there. I don't think that's part of the game, but it's, I think it's a bit something to do with a broken mechanic or something. I don't know. It might be something to do with the game, but at the same time I don't think it would be, considering that the lines are random. Okie dokie. So what are these sea slugs here doing for? Why can we kill them as well with the nail hammer? Oh, I kind of wish I started the episode over here so we didn't have the capabilities of doing such a thing, because these slugs are quite innocent. Sea slugs, however you want to call them. Blue jewelry, red jewelry, green jewelry, orange jewelry. There's a lot of them here actually. Can we kill all of these? Well, a bit of a delayed reaction there. Only one of these is special in a way. Can you attack me? Don't think you can. Right, there's probably gonna be enemies you need to watch out for. Because there's no enemies, I remember ones which look like enemies, but actually karma won't chase us, but if we use Mineo Hammer on them, then they actually are going to chase us. All good in due course though. So yeah, this is not only a lovely environment with lots of jewelry in it and rocks, but there's also a sea environment because of all the bubbles and the creatures that exhibit in here. But of course, our nail hammer is going to show them the way forward. Banish the afterlife. But yeah, these poor slugs. They do not know what's coming towards them. And for goodness sakes, I do not care for it. I'm joking, actually. I do. I very well do, but all of these yummy Nikki fangame protagonists, they're all evil in their own way. It doesn't matter how light the game is. Even though ultraviolet is the lighter side of the spectrum when it comes to yummy Nikki fangames, it's still a little bit evil in a way. Just as using this nail hammer, for example. But we need to find somewhere in which we can use to traverse through the game rather than just simply being in the same world. But if there is an effect item here, then I really would like to see where the heck it is. Per se. We keep encountering these. This is quite a large map, or I keep going through the same area before. There's something distinctive up there though, just witnessed it on the top left. Go through here. And there's something over here. All good. Now what's this over here? Right, we can't go through there, so there's only one way, which is over here. Go through here, and then we shall arrive somewhere, I don't know, this might be Shrek's one, but I do not know, it's all green. It's all greeny poos. Go up here, we'll go, no, there's only one track here, actually. There's only one way. One way, what? Why can't we go behind it? Oh well, go through here then. Seems this is only one way. Which is good. It means there's only one way to traverse through. Something else here. Where is this going to send me? Ah, it's the non-swamp part. Into the watery part. Can we... No, okay, these are transparent, so we can't use them here. Ah, there's something else over there, which means we've got to find... Okay, you. Any of these? Okay, none of these I can probably interact with. Maybe there is one with a distinctive property to it. Which we can visit on it at some point. Insert the nail into a being. Apply pressure to it by using the hammer. And there we go. That's the scientific experiment done and over with. You have created pain. That is the outcome of it all. And going to dead ends is also a pain, but at least it's not a circle. Because circles, in other videos that I've explained, circles are the worst things to encounter within the game. Because you're going through the same thing over and over again. And when that happens, it's obviously very, very bad when you encounter something over and over again, simply because you're always going through the same thing over and over again. Have I been here already? I am starting to think maybe, but let's just go up here a little bit more. I think we encountered a bit of stroke of luck. Here we go. Ooh, a mirror world, as per se. Can I interact with you normally? Window type green. Do you wish to change it now? No, thank you. So this must be Semizuki's dream room. Nah. Hello. Hello, everybody. I would like for you to come over here, please. Nah.
Silence!
We got a coin, but at what cost? Can we open the door? We can turn on the TV. Wait, that wasn't a thing. Was it now? We got 200 yen out of it, though. He's all good. Are you at the desk now? Can I interact with you still? Nope, you're still gonna do that. Okay. Damn it. I feel so guilty, but I wanna see if I get any more coins out of it. Oh no, they're... Wow. I turned off the TV, and now you're going... Damn it. Now I feel bad. Any other positions? Okay, what about if the TV is on? I'm such a cool human being. Any other positions? Nope. Nope, there's no other positions other than the desk. Just going around the room. Or watching the TV. Yeah, it's just gonna be that. Okie dokie, so with that in mind, let's try and explore somewhere else within this nexus. Oh, she's appeared on her bed now, okay. Nah, we're both together now. Back here now in this lovely sea world. And my golly, I am grateful to be back because that place took considerably longer than it needed to escape simply because of the routes kept leading me to that lovely dream room, sorry, the dream room in which we were already in. So, okay. We're going to discover the rest of the sea environment, and then we shall process onwards towards other adventures throughout the entirety of the game. Without this line, hopefully, not going to do something bad to us. Because that to me seems like something bad. We don't want anything bad at all. We want good things. Good things to come out of all this. Not bad things. Not stuff that'll corrupt a computer or anything like that. I mean, that would be very silly, wouldn't it now? Something that does that. Okie dokie. There might be something else here, I do not know. We keep going around this path for a bit of time now, and there seems to be no other viable access points. Or no other access points to be completely honest. There aren't anything, isn't anything else that we can discover at this point in time. So what can we do now that we have the nail hammer aside persuading coins to come out of people? If that does actually, I could only get one coin out of that lovely specimen of ours. We'll leave this world for now, but I'm bound to certain to believe that there is something else there. I feel like I've already been here before, but I'm just going to look through here again just to make sure. I believe we came through this way from another door. Oh, these flowers are pretty distinctive. Lilac flowers. Purplish violet. No, bluish violet. Give me these flowers with this hammer and nail. The lovely duo that will provide us sanity. Castle. We haven't been here before. Oh, what's with these gardens? Hello there. Can I interact with you? Nope. Okay, you're gonna meet the demise. I can't attack you. Nope, it looks like I cannot attack you. Or maybe you're an android, which is why I can't attack you. Okie dokie. What have I become like you? Nope, I cannot. Ah, this only has cosmetic effects. Nothing actually useful. Well, anything could be useful if you think about it, right? Nope, nothing on that door. Nope, nothing on that door neither. I love the fact that it's diagonal. You can't go up that way, which is a bit odd. That's not how buildings work, right? Go through the chapel. and see what lays up ahead. What's in this pane? Nope, nothing then. What do you want? Is anything gonna happen? Anything at all? Anything within this church light? What is in here, though? I can't just be there for nothing. There's gotta be some reason behind all this. Surely there's gonna be something which gives us more than just church light. Okay, let's have a bit more of a normal face. No, I don't think anything's gonna contain any sort of secrets. Nothing distinctive about that. Unless there is something up there which I need to decode. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 tiles which we can interact with. 1 dial. 2, 3, 4 tiles. Right, can we go in here? No, we cannot. Right, what can we do with that then? Can we bust it open with the nail and hammer? No, we cannot. What can we do then to inspire our needs to try and find something in this town? Can we go this way then? We can go through this way, and it's quite the muggy forest. This is amazing. Bunnies! Lovely bunnies! Hello, bunnies! Aww. No! I feel so bad, but I want to see if you got any money on you. Hey, some of you run very fast. Hey! Hey, come over here! I've got some wabbit to eat. Got some wabbit! We are hunting wabbit. Hunting wabbit! Is hunting all the wabbits do something, or is this literally it? No, it's not it. There's another path over here. Are there any more wabbits? Or any other animals, to be exact? Is there like a carnivorous rabbit at the end of this? Is there going to be something which is going to completely devour me up, but all I'm going to see is a lovely big ball of fur? Simply because it's a carnivorous rabbit. I wonder if there's any films about carnivorous rabbits. Hi there! I didn't kill any of your rabbit pets, to be honest. It was the nail and hammer that did that. I'm joking. You always blame the person that does the crime. Not the tool. The tool is just a tool. The person is what executes the tool to do such a thing which caused such an effect. And that being is the killing. The person kills, not the weapon that kills. It's like playing a violent video game and then parents blaming the video game itself for being violent, rather than actually looking at the game itself and thinking, you know what, this game may not be suitable for my child, despite them keep going on about this particular game from their friends, well, the same age as them. So yeah, never blame the video game, because that is just a stupid metaphor. Because it's just literally not existent. You can't blame the video game if your child suddenly behaves abnormally. It's your fault for allowing them to have that in the first instance. Right, something over there. I'm pretty sure I'm going to need an item of some sort so I can interact with you properly. Because at the moment, I can't really do much. Let's go down this way then, over here. So there's that purple murky forest. We need an effect item to be able to interact with that. And this, of course, that also gives us an effect as well, that monster. But I'm still curious as to what it actually... Thanks for giving me all those eyes. Just want to need more jump scares. Quote unquote. Not many jump scares can really scare me. I'm quite used to this sort of a tone. Okay, this place is like an alternate version of that pub, but this time around, it's quite gloomy at the same time as well. Let's go through here and see what evidence we can find. There's many stairs here. Let's go over here first. Shall we go up or down? No, we'll go down first, then go up. Let's go down here. Let's go over here. Oh, there's so many different avenues to choose from. Unless this is continuous, actually. Maybe continuous up and downstairs. Maybe it will just lead to the same destination. We may never know about that. What we do know at the moment is that we need to explore. Explore, examine, discover, repeat. Until we find something. But at the moment, it doesn't seem like we have found anything that is of distinctfulness here. And do you know what we've done? We just went round a big loop. So that's a good sign and a bad sign. Let's try something else then. Let's try going down again, and this time going this way instead, and then go down here, and then down again. Wait, these candles seem to be reoccurring, no matter. Oh! It lit red. Do we need to do that to all the candles? Light them all up. Do they go out after a certain amount of time, or do we have enough time to light more red? Okie dokie, so that's a new discovery. Light all the candles red. We'll just light them all up in general, you never know. Okay, so go over here. Okay, so you need to light them all up. So in that case, hopefully when I light them all up, it's going to open up something for me. Hopefully it's going to do that. If not, then I'm not going to be very happy. We've done all this exploring, only to find that these candles only light up. But we don't really do anything on that matter. Okay. Go over here. I believe we've already been here. What the heck? This feels like deja vu to me. Not the song. Just reoccurring experiences. Ever repeat that song of deja vu. That is the meme that should never come about. Book! More books! Even more books! Two chairs here. What could that mean, actually? Something to do with cancelling. Why would there be two chairs that close to one? Just go faster. There's a door there. What if that was it? Was that door there before? Oh, okay. Can I interact with you? I am now said magician. Aha! I need two more flames. I need two more flames to activate something. Oh, I want to do that. I so want to do that. But first... Ryo! Not really, actually. Actually, no, I'll take that back. That's really horrible. No, I was about to say nail you, but that's not much better, actually. Nope. Nails and screws are the same thing, essentially. Much still in our days of light. We found another candle, so it's confirmed. There are five candles in this place. I just gotta actually get there, though. Aha, here's another candle. Good on me. Good. Four. There's just one more to get. There's gotta be some sort of special event awaiting when we find the last candle and go back into that room. Oh, here we go! Yes, as we were speaking about it. Yes! Okay, we're finally back. Very good. It's been whizzing around ages. It's not an easy place to find. Okay, we've got all five circles. What happens now? We did all that just for a window type. Well done, folks. Spend about 15 minutes trying to find all those 5 candles and get back to here, only to realize but it only gives us a new window type. Still, one less mystery down and out of account. Can I talk with you? You haven't got a face. You seem very disturbed. You see, now their mood has changed and now they're running away. Hey, you cannot run away. Doesn't matter how far you run. It just seems like the worst fate as well. Be cornered and then killed. Don't want to think about that actually now. Okie dokie, folks. We are going to go back in due course. And to do that, we're going to use our beloved egg to do that. So I think that is going to be it for today for part 3 on my walkthrough of Ultraviolet. In the next time, we're going to be doing this door, this door, and this door. And then after that, we shall be doing an all effects location, all windows location, all events locations, and pre-requirements to that. So, and hopefully we'll be able to find an ending as well. If not, then it's just going to be the case of all effects, all windows, all events. So thank you very much for watching, folks. And we shall see each other in the next time of Yummy, sorry, of Ultraviolet. I'm almost about to say Yummy Nikki there. I remember these are Yummy Nikki fan games, but you know what? We're just going to live with it and just see to it as well. So thank you very much for watching, guys, and take care of yourselves.